They're live streaming. So I'm now officially a lychee farmer. I have my farmer's hat on and we're ready to go into the lychee orchards. Hi and welcome back. Today I'm here in Zhengcheng in Guangdong province. There's a very special reason I'm here. This is the home of lychee. And today I'm going to show you how technology, a partnership between Huawei and China Unicom here in Guangdong, so people can live stream, sell and advertise the lychee from this area. And it's amazing in China how this technology is being brought into agriculture to really help the farmers. I mean, this is a very, very rural area. You wouldn't expect to have a signal and a connection, a network able to provide high bandwidth upload speed so people can live stream, but that's exactly what's happening. So basically, you know when the lychees are ready to pick because the outside skin goes a nice sort of kind of a strawberry red color. So as this one here, this is not ripe yet because it's still green, and this is obviously one that's very ripened here. This is what lychees when they are ready to pick. So let's pick one. Yeah, let's pick this one, and then we will peel the shell off. Oh, look how soft and juicy that looks. Wow. So we will, excuse me for throwing the peel on the floor, but it is biodegradable. Oh my god, the juice is just flowing out of that. And then oh my god, that is so sweet and juicy. That is delicious. Oh my god, that must be one of the sweetest lychees I think I've ever eaten. That's really, really nice. I can see myself eating more of these before the day's out for sure. I don't know whether you're supposed to leave the stem on or whether you're meant to take the stem off. Are you meant to leave it on?
Yeah,
like this, right? Okay, so yeah, you're meant to leave the stem on the lychee, not take it off. Because of the technology they're using here, they're able to sell and ship them pretty much directly from the orchard, and I would imagine most parts of China you will be able to get them the following day, and they will pack them in a nice box, which is like a refrigerator style box with some ice pack in there to keep them nice and chilled so they don't spoil on the way. So lychees have a nickname, and their nickname is the king of fruits, and they only have a very short window. And we're in Zhengcheng, and it's in June, and this is the peak season for the lychee. I think the season only lasts for about a month or 6 weeks in total. And that's why technology is so important, because lychees are best when they're freshly picked. So the quicker they can get them picked and into your hands to eat, the better they will taste. And those are absolutely delicious. I can't believe my hands are covered in the juice. Delicious. So this guy is now live streaming, and he's talking all about the lychees, and you can see he's got his teleprompter over here, so he knows what he's got to say. And we got the guy here controlling it all. Here you can see it on a phone. This is the live broadcast which he was looking at just a minute or so ago, right behind me, and you can see all the comments coming in. And I guess, I'm not 100% sure, but I guess you can actually probably order directly from there. So this is how live streaming is used, and we're in the middle of a very rural area, so it's very important that we have a good network connection. And I would like to know how the technology has changed the way you work. So tell me what it was like before, and now you have this technology, what it's like.
Like before, it is a relatively traditional sales channel. There is also more traditional planting model, maybe a hoe or some traditional farming tools. In terms of planting, our orchard has undergone a mechanization transformation. We have mechanized everything from planting, like picking, daily mowing, spraying, etc. Then in sales, technology has brought us a lot. For example, we now have 5G, live broadcast and short video promotion, brought us closer to consumers. Then we can show them the better environment and tastier lychees in our orchard in a more realistic and clearer way. To attract them to come to our orchard to pick lychees or directly buy our lychees. The previous 5G signal was unstable and not in every place in the orchard had a signal. Now with 5GA, we have a stable signal in every corner of the orchard and it is fast. We can move around freely during live broadcast and there will be no lag in any corner. And the live broadcast picture is clearer than before. This will improve the conversion rate in our live streaming room.
I have another question. How long have you and your family been involved with lychees?
Our orchard is more than 30 years old. This orchard has been passed down for 3 generations.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. And you're Guangdong Ren?
Yeah.
Yeah. From here?
Yeah.
Jilly. Wow, wow. Thank you very much.
Yes.
I really appreciate it. Thank you. So as you can see, we have a downlink speed approaching, well, over 900 and an uplink speed of approaching 500, which is extremely good. And it's uplink what's required for live streaming. The uplink is much more important than the downlink.
China Unicom Guangdong was the first to partner with Huawei to provide a dedicated package for live streamers that guarantees a minimum upload bandwidth and avoids dropouts, and is helping villagers increase the sales of local agricultural products and supporting the high quality development of many villages. This in turn allows them to stream at a much higher quality, which leads to higher viewership and increased sales.
Right, I'm about to try some lychee coffee. Oh, that is indeed extremely refreshing. It's very light. It hasn't got a strong taste of lychee, but that's very, very nice. That's very, very refreshing. It's a cold brew, handmade coffee, and it's good. I've never seen this before, but I'll be wanting to see it again because it's very nice. Lychee has over 2,000 years of history in Zhenteng in Guangzhou. And we are now at a lychee exhibition. We're going to learn a little bit about the culture and the different kinds of lychee. I had no idea there was different kinds. There's many, many different kinds. There are actually 70 different types of lychee. I thought there was just one. So I'm kind of surprised that there are so many. You know, look at all of those different ones. Amazing how many there are. Wow. Absolutely incredible. I had no idea. Yeah, in old times they would have been transported in these containers and pots here. It's very different now. It's in refrigerated boxes. Okay, and this is a sort of more modern one that's not as easily breakable.
In ancient times, lychees were considered precious. Many poets wrote and chanted their praises. The lychee poems written by this poet were widely circulated. However, due to the lack of technology, it was very difficult for people in these ancient times to eat fresh lychees. But now, with the development of technology and supply chain logistics, it is no longer an issue. People, not just in China, but all around the world, can enjoy the sweet and juicy taste of Zhenteng lychees.